Alright, so in this video I'm going to be teaching a card trick with a deck of playing cards, all you need. So I'm teaching two ways of doing it. One is maybe you're a beginner and you've never really done any magic before and you're looking to get into it. This is going to be a trick that is very easy to do and you can just practice it a few times then try and perform it on someone and it's really good and people have no idea how you do it. And the second one is maybe if you've been doing magic for a while and you want to get into it more and learn some more advanced intermediate tricks without a slight, things like that. So I will leave a timestamp in the description if you want to go straight to the advanced one. Alright, so here's the performance. And yeah, so I have the spectator choose a playing card. It really is a free choice. Say they choose that one right there. So I'm going to show it to the camera. I'm not going to look. Okay, you've got it. Now, I ask the spectator to place it in the center of the deck and just slide it in like that. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the deck behind my back. And I'm just going to run through and see if I can feel with my fingertips your card and try to flip it over on the deck. Alrighty, I think I've got it. So, this deck, all cards are face down. I'm gonna run through the deck. All of the cards are face down, except for one card, spectator's card, in this case, the Ace of Hearts. And you can keep going through and none of the other cards are face up. Alrighty, so. This trick, how it's done, is before the trick starts, you're going to need to have one card faced up on the bottom of the deck. So, very simple to do. Like, you can do it in front of a spectator, just like that, flipping it over on the bottom of the deck. I've never had a spectator notice that before, so basically just slide it off with your fingertips and flip it over, okay? Just like that. Now, next thing you're going to need to do is just run through the pack and have the spectator choose a card. And it really can be any card. Just when you spread it out, make sure you don't flash the bottom card there. So only spread to in the middle and then have them choose the card. Okay. And then you show it to them. And in this case, the card is the 10 of spades. And so you show it to them. And what you do while you show it to them, because they're going to be looking at the card that you're showing to them, not your hand. So, when you show it to them, they're going to be looking at the card, and you're just going to turn your hand over. And so what that does is it has all of the cards face up except for the one on the top. So it looks like they are all face down, but in reality, they're all face up except for the one card. So, but the spectator doesn't know that. So, now what you ask them to do is place it in the middle, face down. And so what it looks like to them is they're placing it in a deck of face down cards, mixing it in. But in reality, they're putting it in a deck of face up playing cards. So their card is going to be face down. Now what you say is you tell them that you're going to put the deck behind your back. And you, really, you can say anything. You like, I just like to say that I'm going to run through and turn over the deck and, I'm sorry, the card. Run through and try to feel the card out with my fingertips and turn it over. And so what you're really doing when you put it behind your back is you're just flipping the top card over so that it's face out with the rest of the cards. So I put it behind my back and what's happening is I'm just flipping that top card over and then turning the entire pack over. So now what's happened is every card really is face down except for the spectator's card. And you can keep running through the deck and there is no other card face up. And so you can do any kind of reveal. You can, you know, go very dramatically, quietly until you see the card. Or you could really even flip the entire deck over and it's more mysterious so that when they see the card, they don't know that it's a card right away until you do reveal. So, also you can do any kind of ribbon spread if you know how to do any of those. Comment down below if you would like me to teach how to do that in a future video. So, that is the beginner way of doing it. And so, yeah. Alrighty, now for the more advanced performance or way of doing the trick. So, for you people who have been doing magic for a while and you're wanting to learn some harder, more advanced magic, this is for you. So, I'm just going to go through the performance. So, spectator can shuffle the deck. I give it back. I shuffle the deck a little bit, maybe. Square up the cards. Now, once again, I run through the deck and have the spectator choose a card. Just like that. Now, they look at it. And then I ask them to place it back in the middle of the deck. And now, we've got the deck, and their card is somewhere in the middle. So, basically, have the deck. And now you can do the reveal. You can just go through the deck, and their card will be face up in the middle, and the only face up card. So, this trick is going to require a sleight and some sleight of hand that I will show you right here. So what it is I'm gonna be passing a card to the bottom of the deck, like that. So, show you once more. Exposed view, like that. So what's happening is I'm holding the deck with my three fingers and thumb on the back. And I'm taking my other hand, my left hand in this, and I'm coming around like this and just grabbing the deck and sliding off a card, top card, with my four fingers, just like that, and sliding it onto the bottom of the deck. Now, if this is done correctly, the right hand will be covering it, and if the correct misdirection is applied, then the spectator will not notice. So, basically, sliding off the deck, just like that. So, go ahead and practice that a few times. Come around, slide it off like that. So, and if it's done correctly, you can just be talking or your spectator and do it. And, yeah. So, now for the trick. So, what's different about this performance and the second one is the first one, I had to put it behind my back to turn over the card that was face down. This one I don't. I can do it right in front of their eyes with that slight. So, basically, and as you saw, there was no card face up before the trick. So, you can let the spectator shuffle anything, and then you take it back and shuffle it a little bit. And now what you're going to do, what you're going to do is that pass. So what you're going to do is just take the card, add in the square, so you just shuffle it, and you start to square up the cards, and then you do that in the squaring up action, which makes it so that there is one card face up on the bottom of the deck. And now what you do, you do the same thing, have them choose a card from the center of the deck, and again, you don't want to flash that last card, so you just want to spread through the middle and have them choose one out of the middle, like that. And then, same as the earlier performance, when they're looking at the card, because remember they're not looking at your hand when they're looking at their card. And so as soon as they're looking at your card, what you're going to do is you're just going to turn over your hand, like that. Simple action. So they're looking at the card, I flip over my hand. Then I have the spectator just slip it in the center. Nothing tricky there. And I'm going to use the same method, but this time it's going to be a little bit harder to use. Because, you see, if I do it right here, they'll see that the other card is face up. So I can't have that happen. So, and at this point, their card is one of the only face card, face down cards in the deck. So basically what you're going to do is you're going to, and you can't let them know you're flipping over the deck either, because you're going to have to flip it over. So What I like to do is I kind of like to do an action that looks like kind of I'm just turning over the deck. And so it's like this. I'm just like that. So what I'm doing there is, once again, I do it as I'm starting to do this action. Well, I just do that. So once again. And yeah, so now you can do some kind of reveal and you can go through dramatically, once again, reveal that their card is the only face-up one in the deck. Or once again, you can go through with the cards face-up and it can be more mysterious, even more dramatic. Because they don't really know that it is their card yet, then you do the reveal. So. Yep, I hoped you liked that, so, yeah. Also, some further tips on the trick. So, if you, after the card is turned over on the deck, and you want to make it even more convincing, you can do some more shuffling on the deck. A riffle shuffle, basically. A normal riffle shuffle is you're taking away, or you're picking up the deck and peeling cards off with your thumb as you go down like that, and you can peel off different numbers, like it doesn't have to be one card at a time. So what I'm doing here is if we have the card turned over, like in the middle of the performance, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take my fingers that I'm holding the deck with, and instead of holding them like this, I'm going to bring them up here so that when I pull out part of the deck, those bottom cards stay. And I just continue to shuffle. And I can do that as many times as I want. So, but what you don't want to do is just peel off the back card because you may flash when you come up. So, once again, just like that. So, yeah. And another tip is that in the more advanced one trick, version of the trick, when you do that slight, it's best if you do it while you're in the middle of a movement. So don't just be still and then make a sudden movement. It's best to cover it with another action. So, you know, you're moving around and then you do it. Much less likely that the spectator will notice the trick. So yeah, thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please smash the like button. And if you like this kind of video, then subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss any other kinds of videos. Tell me what you thought of this video in the comments. Did you like it? Did you not like it even? You can talk about that. I would love it if you share this video with anyone. And